Hello everyone, welcome to Analog IAS. Today we are going to discuss about the differences between Eastern and Western Ghats. The Deccan Plateau is bordered by Western Ghats in the west, Eastern Ghats in the east, Satpura, Michael Range and Mahadev Hills to the north. Now let us see about Western Ghats. The Western Ghats lie parallel to the western coast. They are continuous and be crossed through passes only. Also, Western Ghats are higher than Eastern Ghats. The Western Ghats cause orographic rain by facing the rain-bearing moist winds to rise along the western slopes of the Ghats. The highest peak of Western Ghats is located in Annaimudi Hills, followed by Doddabetta Peak in Nilgiri Hills. Most of the peninsular rivers have their origin in the Western Ghats, like Krishna, Godavari and Kaveri. Also, the Western Ghats are locally known by different names like Sahyadri in Maharashtra, Nilgiri Hills in Karnataka and Tamil Nadu and Cardamom Hills in Kerala. Now, let us discuss about Eastern Ghats. Eastern Ghats stretch from Mahanadi Valley to the Nilgiris in the south. These Eastern Ghats are discontinuous, irregular and dissected by rivers draining into Bay of Bengal. Eastern Ghats are highly eroded by rivers like Mahanadi, Godavari and Krishna etc. Some of the important ranges of Eastern Ghats are Javadi Hills, Palakonda Range, Nallamalla Hills and Mahendragiri Hills. Mahendragiri Hills is highest peak in the Eastern Ghats. Now, let us see a previous year question based on this. From the ecological point of view, which one of the following assumes importance in being a good link between Eastern Ghats and Western Ghats? A. Satyamangalam Tiger Reserve, B. Nallamalla Forest, C. Nagarhole National Park, D. Seshachalam Biosphere Reserve. The answer is A. Satyamangalam Tiger Reserve. You can refer back to the earlier slide to see the map to have a better idea. Thank you.